the giant squid is a good symbol of all the things that are unknown about the vast deep ocean.
But it's not just their size that enthralls our imagination. It's that they're so elusive.
When giant squid are found, they're usually found floating at the ocean surface or washed ashore one at a time.
Irrefutable proof of monsters lurking in the deep.
But what we don't really have a good sense of is how many of them there are in the world's oceans.
Perhaps the biggest unanswered question about the ocean's biggest mystery. As the curator of mollusks at the Delaware Museum of Natural History, Dr. Liz Shea researches cephalopods, from gigantic mysteries to more manageable cases.
One of the things I like about my work is that I have lots of different kind of pathways to discovery.
Her inquiries often lead her into the museum's extensive collections.
So we have squids and octopus that were collected from a variety of deep sea explorations, and we were in different places up and down the East Coast.
So little is known about many of these creatures of the deep that just deducing their species requires more than mere observation.
We have two small Dumbo octopus eggs with hatchlings in them that we have done some MRI analysis and micro CT, so we're able to look inside the animal, and we're going to try to use that information to figure out which species these octopus belong to.
Poking and prying open a specimen like these brachiotoothous squid may provide hints about their life cycles.
We noticed that there were kind of two different morphologies that were being collected, one that was light and one that was dark. So the question became then, are these two different species?
DNA testing proved they were not.
So right now we are going back through our collection and we're trying to get a sense of, is it true that all the males are light and all the females are dark?
And at what age do they reach sexual maturity? Dissections like these are even more revealing for rare specimens, like the giant Archituthis.
So I've been working with Clyde Roper and the Smithsonian for a lot of years. We were able to add to Clyde's long list of dissections and morphometric analysis of giant squid.
In addition to getting an up-close view of their durable beaks, you'll discover giant squids are not of the improbable proportions of lore.
It's more common to have a mantle length of about 1 to 2 meters.
But still,
that's nothing to sneeze at. That is a lot of squid.
What you won't deduce is how many of these behemoths are out there. To find that out, you'll usually have to look deeper.
So I've been very fortunate to be able to be included in some of the research that the National Marine Fisheries Service has done.
With the help of remotely operated vehicles, Dr. Shea and colleagues scour footage and pictures to catalog species living around 1,000 to 2,000 meters deep.
So we're often along the edges of habitats where there is a big drop-off behind, you know, in the scene. And so that's often where all the action is.
What are they looking for? Anything, really.
Right now, we're doing some basic exploration. You know, who's here when, and where are they located? We see a lot of big purple octopus called Granuledni varicosa. We see tiny little purple potato-y rossia, like little purple muppets sitting on the bottom of the ocean floor. And then occasionally, if you're lucky, you'll see a Dumbo octopus fin flapping on their way through the water column.
Yet despite the unusual suspects, there's only been two brief sightings of giant squid in the deep ocean, certainly not enough to make an estimate of their populations. With limited data, Dr. Shea, Dr. Roper, and colleagues turn to the animal that knows the giant squid best, their natural predator, the sperm whale.
One of the ways to understand what sperm whales eat is by looking inside the stomach and looking at the beaks that are present in the stomach of a sperm whale.
It was those durable beaks that provided enough evidence to make a calculated estimate.
So we just sat down with a pencil and paper and said, okay, well, say that there's 360 or 350,000 whales left and they eat one squid a month. Let's just do the math.
We arrive at a seemingly impossible figure.
So there's a lot of challenges wrapped around that number. We don't know that sperm whales eat one a month.
They could actually eat less, or they could eat more. If they eat one per week, you get
over 130 million giant squids in the world's oceans. Those numbers are, you know, what could be at its outermost extreme. And they're big numbers, but it's the biggest unexplored area on the Earth.
What this means is that the ocean's most epic battle of titans is actually fairly commonplace and could be happening right now, and again right now, and again right now, and again right now. For our tentacled overlords, I'm Luke Groskin.